Hello everybody, I hope you all are doing good. So today we are going to do Merchant of Venice. It is a quick revision we'll be doing. Okay, this will be very quick. So let's start with Act 3, Scene 1. I'll give you a full summary of that. Okay, in first Scene 1. So Lanio and Solerino discuss the rumor that Antonio has yet a second, has lost a second ship. Shylock enters and complains that both Solanio and Solerino had something to do with his daughter's flight. They do not deny it, but instead ask Shylock if he was heard about Antonio's losses. Shylock tells them that Antonio should look to his bond and make sure he repays the money, or else Shylock is planning on taking his pound of flesh. Shylock is furious with Antonio, whom he blames for the loss of Jessica, and also bears an older grudge against him. He then delivers his famous thing, that is, had not a Jew hands, organs, dimensions, senses, affections, passions, etc. The speech concludes with Shylock saying that he will take revenge for all the time he has been treated badly by Christians. Here by Christians, he means Antonio. By Antonio. And this I'll be uploading in my Telegram channel if you want the notes. One of Antonio's servants arrives and bids Solanio and Solerino to go to Antonio's house. They leave, and Tubal, another Jew, arrives to speak with Shylock. Tubal has been in Genoa, where he tried to locate Jessica. He tells Shylock that Jessica had been in the city and had spent over 80 ducats while there. She had also traded turquoise ring for a monkey, a ring which Shylock regrets losing because he had received it from his wife Lei. However, Tubal also brings the news that Antonio had lost yet a third ship and is almost certain to go bankrupt in the near future. Shylock is excited by this news, since he had decided that he would rather take revenge on Antonio than receive his 3,000 ducats back. Means he is wanting to do forfeiture of his bond. Act 3, Scene 2. Portia. Portia tells Bassanio that he wants him to wait a month or two before choosing from the caskets, so that she may be guaranteed by his company for a while longer. Bassanio tells her that he is desperate to choose and feels like he is being tortured the longer he waits. Portia finally agrees to take him into the room with the caskets. Portia orders music to be played for Bassanio, and one of her servants starts to sing a song in which the rhyme all rhyme with the beat. Bassanio speaks directly to the audience and tells them that many things are glided and coated with ornaments. He therefore decides to do away with gold, comparing it to mirrors, agreed. The silver casket he also ignores, saying it resembles money and is therefore too common. He thus chooses the lead casket and finds Portia's picture inside. Bassanio is overjoyed by the picture and remarks that it is a beautiful counterfeit. He then takes the scroll and reads it. You, who has choose, not by the view. Chance as fair and choose as true. Bassanio goes over to Portia with the note, and she offers him everything she owns, including herself. Portia then hands Bassanio's ring as a token of her love and commitment and tells him never to part away with it. He promises, telling her that if he ever stops wearing the ring, it will be because he is dead. Graciano then informs them that he would like to be married as well. He tells Bassanio and Portia that he had he and Nerissa are in love. Bassanio is thrilled for his friend and agrees to let them get married as well. Jessica, Lorenzo, and Salerio arrive at Belmont. Bassanio is happy to see all them, but Salerio then hands him a letter from Antonio. Bassanio turns pale at the news that Antonio had lost his fortune and his ships, and he asks Salerio if it is true that all of Antonio's ventures have failed. Salerio tells him it is true, and that Shylock is so excited about getting his pound of flesh that even if Antonio could repay him, he would likely refuse it. Portia asks what amount of money Antonio owes to Shylock, and then orders Bassanio to return to Venice and offer Shylock 6,000 ducats to destroy the contract. She informs Bassanio and Graciano that she and Nerissa will live like widows in their absence. They all agree to get married first and then go straight to Venice to rescue Antonio. Means first of all they married, then they will be going to Venice. Act 3, Scene 3. Shylock drags Antonio to jail. He turns a deaf ear to all of Antonio's wants and warns him of all the time he had called Shylock a dog, that the dog's bite is about to happen. Shylock is confident that Duke will grant him justice. Salerno calls Shylock the worst of men, to which Antonio replies that it's his fault as his way of giving loans with interest has incurred losses for Shylock. Salerno assure him that the Duke will never let things happen according to Shylock, but Antonio remains skeptic. He says that Venice has a great reputation for upholding laws and ensuring justice, and the Duke will in no way break the law for economic sufferance. Antonio says aside that he has no more wish left apart from seeing Bassanio for one last time. Act 3, Scene 4. Meanwhile, Portia frets over her husband, to which Lorenzo assured her that if she knew Antonio half as well as he did, she will see how the praises are in comparison to his great self. Portia replies that she has never regretted any decision in her life, and any close friend of Bassanio is close to her. She says that agar wo dost Bassanio, say like it is, he's closer to Bassanio than, as Bassanio is my husband, he's closer to me too. She hopes that Antonio will be spared and announces that until Bassanio returns, Nerissa and she will be taking refuge in a nearby monastery and living a life in prayer and contemplation. Jessica and Lorenzo are kept in charge of managing Portia's estate. Portia sends one of her servants, Balthazar, to Padua to meet her cousin, Dr. Bellario, who will provide him with some documents and garment which Balthazar is to bring to them in Venice. Portia and Nerissa departs for Venice, dressed as young men. Nerissa asks the reason for such a secret visit to Venice, to which Portia replies that she will unfold the plan to her on the coach ride. So here, Nerissa and Portia are lying to Lorenzo and Jessica that they are going to monastery, while they are going to Antonio to help him from the Viscous Jew. Act 3, Scene 5. Launcelot and Jessica are in an argument over whether she can be saved by God since she was born a Jew. Launcelot tells her that since both her parents are Jews, she's reminded. She protests the and can be saved once she becomes a Christian, because her husband Lorenzo is a Christian. Launcelot then makes a joke and says that Lorenzo is a bad man because by converting all the Jews, he is praising the price of pork, since Jews do not eat pork, but Christians do. Lorenzo then arrives and orders Lonestar to go inside and prepare the table for dinner. He and Jessica praise Portia for being such a wonderful hostess before entering the house to get their dinner. Okay.
Oh my, it is raining.
Act 4, Scene 1. Antonio's trial begins in the court. The Duke expresses his grief over Antonio's condition and calls Shylock as evil and malicious, as to human would inflict such harm on another human. Antonio responds by saying that he knows how much the Duke has tried to do things in his power, but Shylock's evil intentions cannot be judged, and that he has nothing else but to follow Shylock into his doom. The Duke then calls for Shylock and tells him, in thinking about the horrific act he is doing. He says that Shylock is doing this only to scare Antonio, that there isn't any proper reason to do so. Shylock remains silent throughout. At the end, he says that personal reasons and his hatred toward Antonio is enough for him to seek his revenge. He's very cruel. This is what it shows. Bassanio has arrived at Venice and rushes to argue and plead with Shylock to show mercy on his friend by Antonio. While Antonio warns him that all his pleas will fall on a deaf ear, Bassanio offers to pay 6,000 ducats, twice the original amount, but Shylock denies. Remember this, that Shylock is denying it. Antonio calls out that for some men, hatred and predation comes naturally, like the wolf. The Duke then asks Shylock, how does he expect mercy when he himself has none to show? To which the matter replies that he hasn't done anything wrong. Shylock says that the pound of flesh which I demand of him is dearly bought. This mine, and I will have it. He says that the pound of flesh of Antonio is not even worth 3,000 ducats, but I have purchased at this high price, so I demand it. I want to have it. Okay. It is very simple, but though it is very long, this part is, no, it is very long. The Duke then announces that he is waiting for a learned lawyer judgment when news comes that a mess gamer has arrived from Dr. Bellario, and Salerno rushes to revive him. Bassanio tries to cheer Antonio up in the meanwhile, but not to avail. Nerissa enters dressed as lawyer's clerk and gives the Duke a letter from Bellario. Shylock, in the meanwhile, starts polishing his knife as he is confident that the judgment will not be in the favor, while Graciano called him out for having soul of a wolf. The Duke says that Bellario has sent forth a hound lawyer named Balthazar, who is to preside over the matters, and he beckons for the Balthazar to be brought in. The Duke then sits to read the letter where Bellario had written that he is ill, and instead of coming over himself, he is sending over a learned young lawyer to take the stand in place of him. Portia enters dressed as the young lawyer. Balthazar greets and the Duke that she is aware of the circumstances of the case. Antonio and Shylock are presented in the front of the court, and Portia asks Antonio whether he admits owing money to Shylock. When Antonio admits to that, Portia turns towards Shylock and requests him to show mercy. When asked by Shylock why he should show mercy, Portia quotes one of the greatest speech in this by saying, the quality of mercy is not strained. She says mercy is an attribute of God, and one should exercise by giving the act. Shylock refuses to budge and claims for justice. Portia then asks Antonio whether he will be able to pay back the money. To which Bassanio jumps up and says he's willing to pay twice the sum or even 10 times the amount to save his friend. Bassanio then requests Portia, means right now he does not know that she's Portia, so to the lawyer, that law cannot be undone and justice shall be given. Shylock is overjoyed to hear that and hands over the box. Sorry, I'm very sorry. This was said by Portia. So Shylock was very happy. Portia goes through the bond and declares that the legal and binding, and since Shylock refuses to be merciful, Portia tells Antonio to prepare himself for the knife. Portia, as a last act of mercy, asks Shylock to have a surgeon at hand so that Antonio doesn't bleed to death. But Shylock refuses, as no such claims has been made in the bond. Antonio bids Bassanio farewell and tells him not to grieve after his death, as he has lived life fully with Bassanio and is proving his love for him by dying. Sarcastically, Bassanio and Graciano says that they would have given up their wives only if that means saving him. Portia and Nerissa, upon hearing that, mutters to themselves that their wives will be less appreciative of the sentiment. Shylock finally gets ready and pounces on Antonio for his revenge with the knife in his hand when Portia stops him. She reminds him that according to bond, Shylock is entitled only to one kind of Antonio's flesh, not a pound, more or less. And that if he sheds a drop of blood, then he will be charged for conspiring against a Venetian citizen, and that all of his land and property will be handed over to the state. Shylock slowly realizes that he has pushed himself into the trap, and luckily dismisses it by saying that he will agree to accept 3 times the sum, but Portia stops him, saying that he can only take either a pound of flesh or nothing else. Shylock then drops the case out. Portia then charges him for trying to threaten the life of a Venetian citizen. According to the penalty, half of Shylock's property will be seized by the state and the other half will be given to Antonio, and Shylock must beg for mercy at the hands of the Duke. The Duke tells Shylock that it will be just fine. That it would not be fine, and he will be fined. Shylock begs him to take away his life, as what good will come to him to live without the estate? रुपए नहीं है तो जी क्या क्या करेगा? That's what he's saying, but हर बार पैसा पैसा नहीं होता है. Antonio shows his mercy by giving him back half the estate only. Shylock converts to Christianity, and then he writes in his will that after his death, all his property will go to his daughter, Jessica, and her husband, Lorenzo. Shylock agrees to do it and quickly departs from the scene by saying he is unwell. Arey unwell hi hoga na yaar, itna sara jhanjhat mein fas ke. After the court has been adjourned, the Duke invites Portia to dinner. But Portia declines the offer by saying she and her assistant must haste for Padua. As she is about to depart, the Duke insists Antonio on a parting gift for her saving his life. Bassanio offers 3,000 ducats, whereas Portia is demanding for the ring. But Bassanio says no, kyunki Portia ko usne bola tha ki I will like not give it to anybody. Ab wo to fas gaya, bhai itni madad ki hai lawyer ne. So then to wo log chale gaye. But then he said Graciano, give this ring to that lawyer. वो तो ग्रेशियानो भाग के चला गया और दे दी रिंग. उसे देख के तो पोर्शिया वाज ओह वाव दैट ही हैज गिवन द रिंग, ही हैज ब्रोकन हिज प्रॉमिस. नाउ टू टेक सम मोर मींस टू एंजॉय टू मेक सम फन, नरिसा एज शी इज यू नो शी वाज द क्लर्क, सो शी सेड दैट कैन यू टू गिव मी द रिंग व्हिच यू हैव. सो नाउ ग्रेशियानो Bassanio had given, so Graciano also agreed, so he also gave it away. Now we come to scene 4, ये रिंग वाला ग्रेशियनो का रिंग वाला सीन टू में हुआ था, आई एम वेरी सॉरी. अब सीन वन में एवरीवन रीच टू बेलमोंट एंड देन एवरी लाइक एट द सीन ओपन्स विद बेलमोंट विद लॉरेंजो एंड जेसिका एंड द मूनलाइट कंपेयरिंग देमसेल्फ टू द डिफरेंट क्लासिकल ओवर्स लाइक ट्रॉयलस एंड क्रेसिडा, डीडो एंड एनस एंड सो ऑन. दे गो ऑन बैक एंड फोर्थ डिक्लेयरिंग देयर लव फॉर वन अनदर व्हेन अ मैसेंजर एंटर्स एंड अनाउंसेस दैट पोर्शा विल be returning soon. Jessica and Lorenzo gets ready to meet the mistress of the house when Lancelot enters and announces that Bassanio along with Antonio will be arriving the next day. Lorenzo says that this calls for some music and Jessica sits on the grassy bank while the music plays in the background. As the melody drifts towards them, Lorenzo musters that music is something only possible by the movement of the mystical orbs in the universe. He also says that the people who are moved by the music are some of the wild creatures on earth and deserve the worst cruelties. Portia and Nerissa make way for their home, but even before they have crossed threshold, music reaches their ears and Portia declares that the music is made more beautiful in the night. रात को और अच्छा बना दिया है. दे ग्रीट लॉरेंजो एंड जेसिका एंड पोर्शिया वॉन्ट्स देम नॉट टू मेंशन टू बसानियो अबाउट देयर एब्सेंस. फ्लेयरिंग ऑफ द ट्रम्पेट्स मेंशन टू बसानियो अबाउट सॉरी अनाउंस दैट बसानियो हैज कम अलोंग विद एंटोनियो. दे ग्रीट वन अनदर. बसानियो इंट्रोड्यूसेस हिज फ्रेंड टू हिज वाइफ. पोर्शिया हॉटली वेलकम्स हिम. इन द मीन टाइम Graciano and Nerissa break into a little quarrel. Very good scene. I love this scene. The ring scene. In the meantime, Graciano, they quarrel. When asked by the others, Nerissa mentions that Graciano has already lost their ring bearing their sign of love. Graciano argues that he has given the ring to the clerk of the lawyer who fought for Antonio as a sign of gratitude. Portia announces by saying that that's just an excuse and how Bassanio will never give up his ring. Portia bhi mazay le rahi hai. Portia and Nerissa agrees to that and gives both Bassanio and Graciano respectively another ring for safekeeping. Bassanio and Graciano recognizes the ring ke bhai ye to wahi ring hai jo humne clerk aur lawyer ko di thi. Portia then unravels the entire history by saying she disguised herself as the young lawyer and Nerissa as the clerk and went to Venice to save Antonio's life. Antonio, in the meanwhile, receives some news. This news is also given by Portia only. That his ships and venture are safe and have reached the dock and declares to Lorenzo that he will be the owner of Shylock's estate after his death. The play end in reconciliation and rejoice by all the present characters. Here we come to an end. Thank you everybody. So I hope you understood the whole thing, and I am planning to get those illusions which all are there in Merchant of Venice in the coming video. Okay, thank you.